Elsa Baquerizo. Both teams had quite impressive group stages. Spanish came through Pool D in second. Italians won Pool A. So whoever wins this match, you can see on the graphic there, will, barring a massive upset, face the reigning Olympic champions, Trainer and Walsh, in the quarterfinals. So it's going to be a tough test. But first, one of the teams has got to come through here. And I think because of the seeding system, the way a lot of the first place teams in the groups face the third place or the lucky loser teams, we've seen a couple of unevenly seeded
now
matches.
Let's meet the officials for this game.
Today, where
our first referee from France, Marc Birard. And our second referee from Australia, Katrina Tweedy. Now, let's meet the players. Representing Spain, wearing number one, with 102 major tournament appearances, winning four gold, nine silver, and eight bronze medals. Please welcome Liliana Fernandez-Steiner. Wearing number two, playing in her second Olympics. She has 96 major tournaments under her belt and one gold medal. Give it up for Elsa Baquerizo. Representing Italy, wearing the number one top with 52 major tournaments under her belt and two gold, seven silver and seven bronze medals. Please welcome Marta Menegatti. And her teammate, wearing number two, winning one gold, three silver and seven bronze, giving up for Greta Cicolari. And now, let's hand it over to the officials who will get this game underway.
Until 2011, the Italians were very much a kind of semi-final team. But they've just started cracking some of the podium spots this year. And talking to a lot of people around here, they are one of the most improved teams of 2012 and a very, very good prospect for these games. If they time it right, they could slot into place for them. Cicolari in the net. Interestingly, the Italian male and female sides are mirroring each other. Nicolai and Lupo have made the quarterfinals. Very young, well experienced, but they've taken out the reigning Olympic champions. And if these Italian women couldn't do the same, the quarterfinals when they face the Americans. Get past the Spanish first, though. Spanish have got a lot more games as a team under their belt. They play 6 times. Yeah. It's just 37, but that attack up nicely. Cicolari to serve. So two line blocks. Repeat on the Spanish. Sets. Fantastic spike there from Baquerizo. Lily to serve. At the back of the court. Very bizarre. So, Menegatti to serve. 3-2. Great pass. Attacking as well. So, 3-all. penalty, fantastically placed. The Spanish defence were picked her shot very carefully. Both the Italians 5'11", Fernandez 5'10", Lily Fernandez that is, Baquerizo 5'11", pull block, Cicolari, opted not to go for the block again, nothing she can do about that smash. To serve, Italians lead 8-6. Actually bumping into each other there. No clear call made by either of them. Good sign. Start. See that free kick. Communication and understanding between the players is key. Much better there. Hopefully less and less for the Spanish. Lots of more of that. It's endemic with the Russians earlier on today. They crashed out. Chinese with the attack. Stinging attack there. The Italians, one and a half from that. Baquerizo, and well off the net. Cicolari was down so quickly. Too close to the net. No, but oh, the ball comes off Cicolari. Cicolari conceding that she did touch it. Managed to take the point, 9-11. Lily Tissot. Beautifully onto that ball, the approach was great, the set from Cicolari. Able to carry her momentum through that.
Brought together from 15 countries around the planet, they are simply the best of the best.
Great serve from Baquerizo. Very low to the net now. Menegatti attacking, but Fernandez's block work very, very clever. Great interchange between both sides. Great block. And Baquerizo, after the block, pulled away from the net. Now she approaches again. She gets that touch. Why on earth did Menegatti play that ball? What a rally here. Now Fernandez smashes it. It comes straight back over and both the Spaniards are chasing. The Italians with a very, very important point now. There's some great work at the net earlier on in that point from Baquerizo. And Fernandez took over and I thought she'd got that attack, but somehow Cicolari held on to it. And the Spanish... They've gone timeout. Spanish have gone for a timeout. After the technical timeout. Critical those points. Sometimes it shifts momentum of the game to win one. Psychological advantage of having improvised and made the better of the situation can often then translate just pulling their game together. Spanish aren't risking that at all. Interesting is the Spanish were there. It was the Italians who kept their heads. To serve. 13-10, the Italians lead. Fernandez sets. Cicolari, who then attacks. It's a great play from Cicolari there. Shut down Baquerizo at the net. Fernandez managed to pick it up. Quickly, the Italians back on the offensive. So Fernandez to serve, 11-14. Cicolari to the net. Great work by Baquerizo. Cicolari has been fantastic. Just as I say that, Menegatti put in some sterling work, but the Spanish finish this point. Two back-to-back incredible rallies. The crowd here at Horse Guards Parade, and you, the Olympic viewers at home or wherever you are, certainly getting your money's worth out of this game. To serve. Just 2 points between the teams now. Cicolari knew that was going long. Ducked out of the way. Menegatti serves. Oh, not quite a net touch from Fernandez. And a great strike from Baquerizo gets Menegatti on the run. The Italians, 28 points, change ends. One or two of these points, we'll see Italy pull their time out. Different resurgence from Spain. Cicolari off the block of Fernandez. 16-13. Great work from Menegatti at the back there. Now she jumps at the net. Again, Baquerizo equal to the attack. Gets one of her own in there, and it comes straight back from Menegatti's dig. Oh, but Fernandez decides she's had enough of this doing and throwing. It's at this point. She drove the ball straight down the cul-de-sac under the net of the Italian side of the net. Straight up to Menegatti, great, gets a great roll, just pokes that ball over Fernandez's block and down the line. So Cicolari lines up the serve. Great block from Cicolari. The ball drops straight down in front of Baquerizo. The Italians control of this first set now. No doubt. With only 2 points to reach set point. You can write the Spanish off quite yet. Not with that kind of attack from Baquerizo. So Baquerizo just a little bit long on that serve. To go to set point, just bouncing off the net, 35 points played. Spanish, usually so at home on the player, got their work cut out now, they trail by 5 points. Cicolari, an ace to finish the first set, fantastic work by the Italians. Spanish, questions they're going to have to find some answers to after that first set. Play that badly, a couple of unforced errors might have cost them, but at the net the Italians have been fantastic, and in defence they have been all consuming. Very, very few balls have made it past them untouched. Entertain the crowds between sets. And we've had our break. The players are back. Set to as you can see, the atmosphere here is blazing. First point to the Italians. Menegatti. Straight in the Cicolari sends that back to Cicolari. So Cicolari to serve. Down low for Baquerizo. Cicolari takes it as it comes over the net. And a little poke there. Oh, and somehow the Italians have saved it. Great work from the Spanish. And another little poke from Menegatti. Here comes Baquerizo. And this time she makes sure a clinical shot. A surgical cut right between the Italian women. Lily Fernandez to serve. Service error for the Spanish. Similar amount of service errors between each team. 3 from 17 for the Spanish. 4 from 24. And the Italians. And Baquerizo. Oh, Cicolari pulled away from the block there. Nice delicate touch on it, but Menegatti. couple of service errors here at the start of this set. Nerves from the Spanish. Whatever they do, they need to sort it out very quickly, because these are points that they could rue at the end of this set. Spending two basic serves there. Many sets. Baquerizo off the net and out on his Italian point. Either team could be, well, it, the Italians especially could be 3 points or 4 points. Service errors. Great attack from Menegatti. It was a great dig from Baquerizo, who now they meet at the net together. And the ball comes off the block of Baquerizo. Big point for the Italians. They're very, very pleased with that. So Menegatti makes their way back for the serve. Looking for the space. It wasn't clean grounding. Gatti was as quick as she could be to try and get under it, but it wasn't enough. Spanish. Cling to the Italians, hoping they won't break. Caputo sends it long. Another service error for the Spanish. They really are losing out here. They've got to go back to square one, start with the basics. Let's get the easy things right and everything else can follow. I say that at the moment, Baquerizo certainly. Oh, how did she not touch the net there? Baquerizo now blocking against Cicolari, and she did enough. Waiting a little bit too long for a hit there, got on top of it. Great work from Menegatti, and then Cicolari pushing the ball in for net. So, the Spanish doing so much work to keep themselves in this point by point, and then every single time they squander it with service error. Finally, one that goes well. Ball comes straight back to them. Oh! And Cicolari, a fantastic block in words of Gandalf. You shall not pass. Very important block for the Italians. Having only just got to the service and sent the ball straight back, they gave the momentum to the Spanish, who then get to attack on their own serve. Cicolari rose to the occasion, both literally and metaphorically. Set for Baquerizo. All that work clawing themselves back into it evaporates. 9-6 down. Menegatti to serve. Bouncing. Oh, unfortunate point there. Ball bounces off the net. No acknowledgement from the Italians either towards the Spanish, that some misfortune in there for them. The Spanish have called a timeout. Maybe that's the price of an Olympic knockout game. Wouldn't like to think so. And Menegatti just. They're both low five there. Quite a bit in the men's game, certainly. You get one of those unfortunate points. Just hold their hands up. Acknowledgement. Maybe not an apology, but an acknowledgement.
Entra con más calma, Saidao. Mira dónde se va la
colocación. Es mucho más calmo. Mettiamole
al pacchettino, così ci aiutiamo per attaccare.
There they go, take a bow.
Tira una bella battuta alta dalla rete.
I've just been told Her Majesty the Queen is trying to have a nap in Buckingham Palace, and she's asked kindly if we can keep the noise down, please.
Players coming back out on the court.
I did try, but this is Party Central, population 15,000!
So Menegatti to serve for the Italians. They lead 10-6. Spanish really do need to get back in here. Lovely work by Baquerizo. Not quite as often as the women, but men. A handful of them have perfected the skill of, once the set goes up, having a look at the block and then getting their eyes back on the ball before they hit it, so they can change their attack mid-air. Baquerizo on occasion looks like she's doing that. So sharp. The same way the Spanish lost so many of those points in the first half of this set. Gifted one back via a service error from the Italians. Fernandez. Cicolari. Oh, and a great attack from Marta Menegatti. Just extend that lead again. The next point, it will be a technical timeout. We've played 21. Down the line for Baquerizo, right on the outside, which she did with it, and then delivered a cut shot in return. It sits in front of the Italians. It's the Spanish just in contact with this second set at 9-12.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if you've noticed, but the steam is gently rising off the posh seats in the St. James's Stand. They may have more money than us, but they sweat just the same. Meanwhile, at the centre court,
so players,
it's
getting ready to do better in the second half of the second set. Place in the quarterfinals at stake, and the Italians have the lead as the Spanish fall over each other. And a little giggle there, getting tied up in knots, chasing Marta Menegatti's spike. Nice to see a little bit of smiling down there on court. To distract the Italians, I don't know. Baquerizo deals with that serve just. Now, Lily did a fantastic job there, getting back to her feet and chasing that ball down. Menegatti looking for a spike down the line. But the Spanish did just enough to push them out. I tell you what, that would be a triumph for the game, wouldn't it? Whoever's having the most fun wins. After rising above their little clash, being able to laugh at themselves, the Spanish have won themselves a point. Long may it continue. Oh, he got down well then. Now the ball's ever so close, but perfectly timed for Baquerizo. The Italians call the timeout this time. sadly outplayed for 2 points by the Spanish there. Put themselves very much back into this game. Trail 11-13. Maybe just that little outpouring of laughter. Released a bit of the pressure and allowed them to play the way they want to. Stop thinking about a million odd people who are watching this worldwide. All of the people in their home country who have their hopes pinned on them, willing them on. Back out. Back to the kind of simple errors cost them contention in the first part of this set. They've been chasing the game ever since they committed three very, very simple service area errors at the start of this set. Now, Baquerizo, straight into the block. Cicolari. Lily Fernandez, absolutely positive there was a touch. Lily Fernandez, not happy about that at all. She's approaching the referee. This is not football. There is very little room to manoeuvre with the referee. He delivers a warning. A yellow card for Lily Fernandez. Out to Menegatti. Just long. By less than centimetres, I think. So close. Big call by Baquerizo. Spanish 12-15. Are they going to make their move? Another service error. The 7 points they've given away in this match, uncontested. You just can't expect to win like that. So Baquerizo, that was perfectly measured though. They can do it under pressure, they just need to learn to do it at the start of the point. Fernandez, can she make this one count? Spanish trail 13-16. Very well placed. Italians lead 19-13. To be as close as they are to this. So a few points left. The Spanish are enjoying themselves. Lily Fernandez second guessed herself. She looked like she was going to jump and then she pulled away from the net, maybe hoping to draw Cicolari into a lob there, but wasn't to be. So Cicolari serves straight into the net. frustration there written all over her face. Both of her fists sunk to the ground. No communication between the Spanish again. Going for the same ball. Baquerizo had stood it up, and there's a good chance she would have made the rebound. Instead, they both got their hands in the same place, piled up in the sand. So the Italians now have match point. And to Menegatti to serve. And again, the Spanish get caught up with each other. And there you have it, Greta Cicolari with the final shot. What turned out to be a very straightforward game for the Italians. The Spanish brilliant in places, couldn't find the consistency they needed to really contest the Italians. And they go out in the round of 16 to the Italians in straight sets. The Italians raise their fists. Clap the crowds, safe in the knowledge that they have made it to the quarterfinals. Greta Cicolari and Marta Menegatti are in the quarterfinals. We'll find out later on today who they will face. The reigning Olympic champions, Trainer and Walsh, the Dutch outsiders, Van Eersel and Kaiser.